everyone, welcome to the F World. My name is Darshna and today I'm going to share with you a tutorial on ready-to-wear dhoti which you can make for all the sizes using the same procedure. But in this tutorial, I have used the measurements of a 2-year-old kid. You can customize it as per your requirement and there are certain changes, for example in the crotch area, which needs to be made for the adult dhoti that I'm going to explain you in that section of the tutorial. So watch this tutorial from start to end. As I told you in my previous video that in this channel I am going to share videos only on fashion and food, and for my finance videos you subscribe to my new channel Moneywise. So let's go to my sewing room and start this tutorial. Before beginning, let me give you a tip. Always maintain such a book with you or a scrapbook with you or any diary wherein you make a blueprint of how you are going to proceed with any project. That really makes the job easy and we are not confused, and this really saves a bulk of our time once we start with the tutorial. So for the sake of convenience, I have divided this tutorial into two parts. In the first section, we will see what are the measurements we require and how to take the fabric according to the measurements. In the second part, we will see the cutting and stitching of the dhoti. So let us begin by first seeing what are the measurements you will require for this. There are only two measurements you need to take. First is the hip round, and second is the length of the dhoti. There is a third measurement which we will derive from these measurements, and that is of the crotch. Now in this crotch we have to know two measurements, that is the crotch length and crotch width. So what are this crotch length and width? See, like even in salwars, drafting of the salwars or palazzos or any bottom, you must have seen that we give this section and then we make a curve over here. So this is the length of the crotch and this is the width of the crotch. So these are the measurements. We are going to derive these from the above measurements. Before that, let me first tell you that in this tutorial, I have taken hip round to be 20 inches and length of the dhoti I have taken for to be 19 inches. This is the ready length of the dhoti. So for the crotch length, we are just going to use the formula half the length of the dhoti. So half of 19 comes to be 9.5. So this is going to be the length of the crotch. For the crotch width, you can either use 1.75 for 6 months to 12 months, 1.75 for 1 to 4 year old, 2 for 5 to 8 years, 2.5 for 9 to 12 years, 3 for 13 to 18 or even above that. This is one method. These are the standard crotch widths. In case you are a double XL size person or an XL size person, then you can just use a simple formula. That is, this is one method and this is your hip round divided by 12. This hip round includes ease, that is plus ease. Whatever ease we are going to take for this hip round divided by 12. So 25 upon 12, that comes to 2.08. But this is a kid's dhoti, so I am not going to use this. I am going to use 1.75 as the crotch width. As I told you, this rule you can apply, or this formula you can use when your size is XL or double XL or more than that for adult dhoti. Mark it. If you are making your dhoti for an adult size, then you take care of this. Once this is done, we will figure out what is the fabric we will require. Now I'll share with you the pattern of the dhoti which we are going to make. So our dhoti is going to comprise of two parts. One is the belt part. This is the belt, and bottom is going to be the dhoti. So this is the bottom part and this is the belt part. So first we will decide how to take the length and width of the belt. This is one more change you can make in the adult dhoti. If you want to skip this part, if you don't want to attach the belt to the dhoti, you can totally skip this part and attach the dhoti with a small casing over here for dori. So directly from the casing your dhoti will start in case of adult dhoti. But I prefer using a belt because this really gives a very good fitting in case of any bottom wear. So I am going to make this tutorial with this method. So for the belt section, how you are going to determine the length and width? So this is the width and this is the length. So length of the belt will be your hip round plus ease. So in this case the hip round is 20 plus ease. I'm taking 5 inches over here. You can increase if your size is more, if you're making for a elder person, then you can increase this 5, 6, 7, whatever ease you require. But I'm taking the ease at 5 inches. So the length of my belt will be 25 inches over here. This will be 25 inches. Talking about the width. Width will be 4 inches. If you want, you can make 3 inches, you can make 5 inches. But I think 4 inches is an ideal belt size. Now this belt will include an elastic section also. So determine what is the elastic length you want. If you're like in this case, I'm going to insert an elastic of 1 inch. So what you have to do is that double of this elastic you have to include in this. So width will be 6 inches. So the fabric you will require for the belt will be 25 inches long and 6 inches wide. So you have to take that in the form of a rectangle. What these measurements are, that I will tell you. This is the width, and this width is the total length of the dhoti minus the belt, 19 inches minus belt 4 inches, that came to 15 inches, okay, and plus 1 inch for seaming allowance, which will go in attaching or folding. So 1 inch seaming allowance, that will come to 16 inches. So this is the formula for the width of the fabric you will need. Now coming to the length part, what is the length of the fabric you will require? So the first part is hip round plus ease divided by 2, that is 20 plus 5 divided by 2, that is equal to 12.5. So this is the first part. Now the second part will comprise, this is the second part. Second part will comprise of the crotch width. So here I'll be using 1.75 for a 1 to 4 year. This is the standard chart. You can use this or you can use by using this method. So here I'll be using 1.75. So this crotch width will be 2 times the crotch width. That is 3.5 inches. And this is going to be the third part. So this third part will comprise of the total width of the fabric. So the first part will comprise of 12.5. Second part will comprise of 3.5. And the third part is going to be the total width of the fabric, which we calculated to be 16 inches. So this is going to be 16 inches. So now this total length will comprise of 32 inches by 16 inches. These are the dimensions of the fabric you will need, and these are 2 pieces. So now that everything is done, we will proceed to the cutting and stitching of the dhoti. So as per the measurements, I have cut the fabric. This is 25 inches in length. This is the belt and this is 25 inches in length and 6 inches width. One thing you have to take care about the belt, and that is the strength of the belt. See, this belt is going to bear the weight of the entire dhoti. So it has to be a bit strong. If your fabric is too thin, then take 2 layers. In this case, I have taken 2 layers. I have doubled this fabric and have used for belt. Now this is the bottom part of the dhoti, which also I have cut according to the dimensions I showed it to you. One more thing I want to make clear over here is that this fabric already had some inbuilt lace in it, as you can see over here. This lace, or this border it is. This is a pure silk fabric. Now if you are taking a plain fabric and you want to attach an external lace to it, then do this at this stage only, because after this you won't get a straight fabric like this to attach the lace. So first lay the fabric in this manner. So first part is going to be 12.5 that I have marked. Second part is going to be 3.5, which is going to consist of 2 crotches for front and back part. And third is going to be the width of the fabric. This third part is going to be 16.5. So this is the crotch width of 3.5. Mark the center of that is 1.75, and from that center line mark a perpendicular line. Here we are going to take the crotch length. This was the crotch width. This is going to be the crotch length. And crotch length, as I told you, was half of the total length. So total length of the fabric was 19, and half of that is going to be 9.5. Now in this 9.5, 4 inches will be the belt. So on this fabric we are going to mark 5.5. All you have to do is that just give a simple curve. Now for making the 2 curves identical, what you do is that fold from this line. These are 2 pieces. So this is the bottom part of the dhoti and this is the belt. See, this part, these pleats part, is going to be this curved part. And for doing this, now we will see how to do this. These pleats you are going to attach to the crotch, and this is the only tricky part of the entire dhoti. Rest all is very simple. So pay proper attention how I'm going to do this. So now what we have to do is that first we have to measure the crotch length. How much is this crotch length? So this 16.5, you pleat it in such a manner that the total length will be of 6.5. See, in this manner, now I have pleated this total length of 16 inches into 6.5. I have condensed it into 6.5. Now you give a nice press over this and repeat the same for the other part as well. Now once you make the pleats, as I showed you, you give a basting stitch over here, a kaccha stitch, what you say, of a bigger length, so that you can remove this afterwards. So now what you have to do is that keep the fabrics in such a manner that this is the right side of this leg, left leg, pleated part right side, and this curved part of the other leg, and this is the wrong side. You place side by side. Now what you do is that just drag this and bring the crotch area to fit these pleats. Now once this is done, what I will do is that what you do is that bring it till here, okay, so that this is the right side now, and just turn it inwards and match with the crotch so that you get such pleats. Now you have to give a stitch from here and attach these three parts. This is the pleated part of the second leg, this is the crotch of the second leg, and this is the pleated part of the first leg. So these three parts you have to attach it. I have attached all the three. I have overlocked also these three parts, 1, 2, and 3. As I showed you, I have attached it and it is taking this form. So this is going to be first leg and this is going to be the second leg. See, like in this case, so this part is attached, and this portion over here which is having this lace, we are going to pleat it afterwards, of course, but I'm just showing you how this dhoti is going to take its form, and we are going to attach it from this, so it will look somewhat like this. Now this back crotch is still to be attached, so on this leg you will be having this half portion to be attached. It's still there, and in case of this leg, both the crotches are there, still pending. So what you have to do is that just fold it from the center. Now these are the two crotches which needs to be attached, but you have to not attach it plainly. What you have to do is that turn this inside this way, turn this inside and match this end, 1, 2, and 3, okay, match these ends and proceed exactly in the same manner to attach this crotch. Give a stitch over here and overlock this. There are two things remaining at this stage. First is to make pleats of this and attach it in this manner, this pleated section, front and the back pleats, and then once this is done, we are just going to attach it with the belt part. If you have the border, then what you do is that for till the length of the border, make the first pleat. After that, just arrange randomly. Don't make very small pleats, otherwise what will happen is that it will look a bit bulky over here. As you can see, in case of this dhoti, the border was wide, so the first pleat I made was a wide one. Make sure that your entire border is covered in the first pleat because it has to be in the front. After that, just arrange it in the manner you want, and we are just going to attach it with this way. Okay, just give a stitch over here, and the same thing you have to repeat for this part, back part. So I have attached both these pleats now, front and back, and you can see how beautifully it is looking. The look is coming so beautiful, like the original dhoti, how you wear it. In the same manner it's looking. Now the only portion remaining is the belt part. This portion you have to attach with the belt part. I have attached the belt with the dhoti. You can see this way the dhoti is going to look, and I have made a casing for the elastic as well, and I have left a tiny opening from here over here. Rest all I have sewn. I have just left this portion from where I'll insert the elastic. This is the final dhoti. I have inserted the elastic in the casing. If you don't want to insert elastic, you can just use a dori instead of this. Now there are two things I want to tell you about the length of the dhoti. If you're using it, or if you're making this for a kid, then it's okay if you take an inch or more for the length of the dhoti, because if the kid grows, then even then you can use it. But in case of adults, when you're making the dhoti, do remember that take the length of the dhoti only till the ankle, because dhoti is not floor touching. So while taking the measurement, make sure that you take from waist to only the ankle in case of adults. In my next tutorial, I'm planning to share with you the kurta of this dhoti, so that it becomes a set, or the angarakha style. It can be either of the two, so keep watching.